мотоцикл в землю. Машина в воду. Ой-ой-ой-ой-ой, в воду. Let's take countries. Countries have gender as well. Россия, Аргентина, Америка, Бразилия, Канада, Греция, Италия, Германия, Куба, Таиланд, Китай. I love. Я люблю. Я люблю Россию. Why not U? Try to say Россию or Россию. You sound better. I am grammatically correct. Я люблю Аргентину. Я люблю Америку. Я люблю Бразилию. Бразилию? Бразилию. You. Sounds better. Бразилию. Я люблю Канаду. Я люблю Грецию. Я люблю Италию. Я люблю Германию. Я люблю Кубу. Я люблю... А? Not in here. Я люблю Таиланд. I'm not changing Thailand because it's masculine gender. Okay. Я люблю Китай. Masculine gender ending. I'm not changing China. Я люблю Таиланд, я люблю Китай. Sometimes accusative case take prepositional function. Why bother? Like, there is a prepositional case which is responsible for prepositions. Why accusative case out straightforward guy all of a sudden took a couple of just a few prepositions? Why bother? Like, for example, v, you can see it with accusative and prepositional case. Why? Why he needs that? Okay, let's say машина. If you use prepositional case v машине, it means I'm in the car. If you use accusative case with the same preposition, в машину, what does it mean? Movement. I'm going to the car. And in Russian language, you don't even need to say I'm going to. Into and movement with the tail. You have a feeling that you move in there. You're going into the car, в машину. And when prepositional case, в машине, all plain, I'm just in the car. No movement. В воду. I'm going to the water. And я в воде, in the water. Let's say somebody call you. Where are you? Я в воде. I'm in the water. What's up with you? У тебя как дела? Makes sense now for me. Because when I started to prepare for this lesson and I saw this couple of prepositions that accusative case got into. Well, it's not confusing at all. It actually makes a lot of sense because he's a straightforward guy and he take the preposition and make it even more doing the action forward into something. So it all makes sense now. Now, let's say I'm flying to America, I'm flying to Russia, I'm flying to Italy. How would I say that? Я лечу в. В. To. Why do I think it's accusative case? Why should I use U? Because it's direct. So what I'm doing? Direct move. Я лечу. Лечу в Кубу. Лечу в Америку. В Аргентину. В to. Я лечу в Россию завтра. Tomorrow. Я лечу в Аргентину завтра. Я лечу в Америку. Я лечу в Бразилию. Я лечу в Канаду. Я лечу в Грецию. Я лечу в Италию. Я лечу в Германию. Я лечу в Кубу. Я лечу в Таиланд. Я лечу в Китай. It's the same if I want to Cuba. Я хочу, в Кубу. Я хочу в Италию. Why I'm using accusative case here? Because I'm here, but my mind goes straight to Italy. Direct, like, my thoughts, they're really direct, they're really fast. Я хочу в Италию. It's the same, you want to say? Я хочу в воду. I want to be in the water. Let's say it's a sunny day, and I'm saying, я хочу в воду сейчас. I want to be in the water. Я хочу в воду.
Машина в воду. Прямо в воду.
Земля в иллюминаторе.
Я хочу в весну. I want to be in spring. Я хочу в весну. Я хочу в воду. Я хочу в Америку. Direct. Okay? Movement straight to my work. Straight to shop. For example, я иду на работу. I'm going to work. Я иду в машину. I'm going to my car. Я иду в бар. Я иду в спортзал. Okay. Accusative case and prepositional case. What is this? Я хочу в Россию. I wanna go to Russia. I want to Russia. It's preposition. How do we know it's accusative or prepositional case? Okay. Once again, if I wanna go there, я в Россию, я в Москву, я в Австралию. Я в Таиланд, я на остров, я в воду. Movement. If we will go with prepositional case, I took all the ending from feminine gender, what will happen? If we put prepositional ending, я в России, I'm in Russia. В Москве, I'm in Moscow. В Австралии, I'm in Australia. В Таиланде, I'm in Thailand. На острове, I'm on the island. В воде, I'm in the water. Я хочу в Россию. I wanna go to Russia. If I wanna go there, я в Россию. If we put prepositional ending, я в России, I'm in Russia. Я хочу в Москву. Я в Москву. В Москве. I'm in Moscow. Я в Москве. I'm in Moscow. Я хочу в Австралию. Я в Австралию. В Австралии. I'm in Australia. Я в Австралии. I'm in Australia. Я хочу в Таиланд. Я в Таиланд. В Таиланде. I'm in Thailand. Я в Таиланде. I'm in Thailand. Я хочу на остров. Я на остров. На острове. I'm on the island. Я на острове. Я хочу воду. Я в воду. Movement. В воде. I'm in the water. Я лечу в Россию. Я лечу в Москву. Я лечу в Австралию, я лечу в Таиланд, я лечу на остров, я лечу в воду. Я хочу... It's still emotion. Я хочу в Россию. Я хочу на Кубу. Я хочу в Москву. Movement. What happened? If I wanna say, I wanna come to you. Would I use this? Нет. Нет, абсолютно нет. Тебя? You? Let's say дерево. Дерево, tree. If you say я лечу в тебя, it will be collision. If you say я лечу в дерево, it will look something like this. So, to use the accusative case inter, you need actually a space, like я лечу в Россию, there is a border of the country. And when you flying or even want to go to there, you cross the border. Я хочу в Россию, я хочу в Москву, я хочу в Австралию, я хочу в Таиланд, я хочу на остров, я хочу в воду. Or you can say, я хочу в магазин. Simple, I want to go to shop. Because in the shop, you actually enter the shop, there is like some space in the shop. Whereas you can't say, я лечу в тебя. You only can hit the person. Я лечу в дерево, only if you really want to be inside the tree.
Or if you are cheap or Dale, it probably will be fine. But if you're not, it will be weird to say that.
If you want to say, I want to come to you, use the gentleman case, dative case. I want to give you a visit. Я хочу к тебе. Dative case. Accusative case is more straightforward. It's motion, active. I'm flying to you. Я лечу к тебе. Dative case. Not that accusative case. Я лечу в тебя. I'm flying into you. Stay away, you know? No. Я хочу к тебе. I wanna give my present to you, okay? Dative case. Important. Очень важно. Good thing I mentioned that, really. Okay. Я на кухню. Хочу чай. Устала. На кухню и обратно. Хорошо? I'm back. Made myself a tea. Сделала чай. Где мы остановились? Now we can see that accusative case is always, you know, straightforward. That's why it's often used in sport, especially when you throw punches. Let's say удар, punch or hit, punch in, let's say, нога, leg, so ногу, в ногу, удар в ногу, удар рука, hand, в руку. Плечо, shoulder, neutral gender is not gonna change. Удар в плечо, hit in the shoulder. Голова, удар в голову, head. So, удар в голову. And here we can see that how accusative case is really relevant here because it's actually throwing a punch. It's nothing, it's movement, it's a move. It's a move, it's an advance. Accusative case. Чай.
Кошка атакует собаку. Собака becomes собаку. Кошка атакует собаку.
Брейк, болевой. Зафиксирован болевой.
Он бьет грушу. Груша becomes грушу, because he punching her it. Бьет стекло. Стекло neutral gender doesn't change.
Okay, this is a famous saying about Moscow, about when you're going to Moscow. Я еду в... What's not right here? I'm going to... Москва in basic form. not right. We need to change it to accusative form. Москву. Now it's right. Я еду в Москву. Разгонять. To dissipate. To get rid of sadness. To get rid of depression. So тоска. Again, a basic form. So I'm getting rid of it. Become у. Feminine gender, accusative case. Тоску. Let's change it. Тоску. Mm-hmm. Еду в Москву разгонять тоску. Going to Moscow to have fun. It's always like if I say, ah, я еду в Москву, people can say, разгонять тоску. No, I'm just going for work. And разгонять тоску. And have fun. So, and you can use it, лечу, for example, doesn't matter, I'm flying to Moscow. Еду в Москву разгонять тоску. Going to Moscow to have fun. Okay, motions again. And now we get into a really Russian local conversation, how we actually talk when we're at home with each other. Tools going to car. Инструменты в машину. Инструменты в машину. Инструменты. You should have said they go into the car, but we have accusative case. В машину. Direction to the car. Why I need to bother with everything else? Инструменты в машину. Картошка в кастрюлю. Мороженое в морозилку. Продукты на кухню. Курица в холодильник. Doesn't change because it's masculine gender. Chicken goes to fridge. Рыба в воду. Goes to water. Удар в плечо. Into the shoulder. Let's say голова. Punch to the head. В голову. Удар в голову. Еда на кухню. Шампунь в ванну. Mm-hmm. Always have aim. To wear. На кухню, в ванну, в машину, в холодильник, в морозилку, в Москву. Разгонять тоску. Лечу в Россию. Лечу в дерево. Дерево new to agenda, doesn't change. Садись в машину, get in a car. Садись в машину, get in a car. Метеорит летит на землю. Метеорит летит на землю. Земля becomes землю. Direction. Удар в воду. Самолет в облако. Облако new to agenda, not changing. And as you notice, sometimes we just omit flying to, going to. It's not here anymore. So in Russian speech, it's really normal to omit all these direction verbs because you already know that this is direction that he's flying or he's moving towards it. В облако, meaning the plane flying towards the cloud. Even without saying flying. So, в облако, to the cloud. So, in Russian speech, you omit I'm going to sometimes, and you just simply say, я на работу. Я в пиццерию. I'm going to pizza place, пиццерию. Я в больницу. Going to hospital. Я в школу. I'm to the school. В больницу. Я на работу. Я в дерево. Here you go. So, on your way to work. Accusative case A. It's always, you know, forward.
Мяч, ворота. Ворота plural, not changing. Мяч, ворота.
Гася, ну офигеть. Ать! Ну, я
что, не
видел?
Видишь машины?
Я видела,
господи.
Я не знала, что... Не давёшь на меня!
Они врезались в машину. Прямо в машину.
So yeah, accusative case is so pushy, it's even got into time and space. I don't know how he got there. Sentences when we're talking about time, time limits. For example, I was in Moscow 1 week. Я был в Москве одна неделя. This is a nominative case, nothing happens, it's just basic form. So we need to change it одну неделю. I was in Moscow for 1 week. Через, in every, let's say, I look at my watch every minute. Каждую, every, минуту. Хорошо? I will be in Moscow in 1 week. Я буду в Москве in, через одну неделю. In 1 week. I work every day. Я работаю каждый день. Nothing changed because it's a masculine gender. I work the whole week. Я работала всю неделю. Accusative case. Всю неделю. Я работала весь год. Я работала весь год. Nothing changed because it's masculine gender. Twice a week. Twice a. Дважды в. Дважды в. Because два it's number two. So дважды. I'm going to the gym. Twice a week. Я хожу в спортзал дважды в неделю. В неделю. Not неделя, в неделю. I go to Moscow дважды в год. Twice a year. Nothing changed here. So yeah, accusative case. It got into time also. When did he got there? If we take minuta, minute, feminine gender, неделя, week, feminine gender, and if we say, wait a minute, подожди минуту, you're actually doing kind of action with this minute, you waited the whole minute. So maybe that's why accusative case. Поработай неделю, take a work for 1 week, неделю. So you working this week. You actually working the week. You waiting the minute. Mm-hmm. So maybe that's why accusative case got into time sentences. Interesting.
Танк через дорогу. You can see that accusative case already made a direction, so you don't need to say even he goes across the road. It's implied within accusative case. Танк через дорогу. Я спрашиваю про ложку. Я говорю про ложку.
Okay, sometimes, as you can see, we use accusative case with prepositions за and про, about. For example, thank you for. For. Спасибо за воду. Thank you for water. Работа, work. Помощь. This interesting one, we'll get to this. Help. Квартира, apartment. Спасибо за воду. Thank you for water. Спасибо за работу. Thank you for work. Спасибо за помощь. Thank you for help. помощь. It's a feminine gender, but because it's ending on soft sign, I didn't mention that. If it's a feminine gender and ending on soft sign, it's gonna stay the same. It's not gonna change to U or U. Спасибо за помощь. Didn't change? No, didn't react. Good. Спасибо за квартиру. Thank you for apartment. Let's take masculine. Спасибо за подарок. Подарок. Present. Подарок, it's a present. Спасибо за подарок. Masculine gender, not changing. For example, pay for. I'm girl, so I'm gonna say it from feminine point of view. Я заплатила за воду. I paid for water. Я заплатила за работу. I paid for work. Я заплатила за помощь. Я заплатила за квартиру. I paid for rent. Я заплатила за подарок. Хорошо? Я заплатил за. I paid for. What's not right with the nouns? Я заплатил. I paid for we. I paid for картошка. I paid for fish. So we becomes нас. Us. Now it sounds natural. Я заплатил за нас. Я заплатил за картошку. I paid for potato. Now it sounds natural. Я заплатил за рыбу. I paid for fish. And also when we're talking about it, we talking about it. So we do some action with this, right? My childhood scene comes to mind. Я что-то знаю про тебя. I know something about you. About you. Про меня? About me. So, про меня? Про тебя. Я знаю что-то про тебя. Но я не расскажу про тебя. But I'm not gonna tell anybody. If you give me a candy. Deal? Let's take a quick look to accusative and dative case. If you say курицу, let's imagine that I'm at McDonald's or somewhere in the cafeteria and I'm ordering. I have my money in my arm and I'm saying курицу, пожалуйста. It means I want to buy chicken. I would like to eat chicken. I would like to pay for chicken. Курицу. And if I put dative case, курице, I give this to the chicken. Курице, пожалуйста. Please pass it to the chicken. Really? This is not this kind of place. Курице, пожалуйста. If you insist. So, курицу. And курице. I want chicken. I won't give it to the chicken. Dative case. Ой-ой-ой. You see the endings in Russia, they carry so much information on their tail. Вытираю доску. Вытираю доску. Accusative case. I'm doing this with the board. Вытираю ее доску. Хорошо, let's take this word матрешка. Feminine gender. Матрешка. Это матрешка. I don't know why many people say бабушка. It has nothing to do with this. Бабушка, it's a grandma. And матрешка, it's a Russian doll. Accusative case. Я держу матрешку. Я прячу матрешку. Открываю матрешку. Я прячу деньги в матрешку. Into матрешка. Inside. Матрешку закрываю. Матрешку ее. Accusative case. But sometimes two cases, accusative and dative case, can be confused. For example, я доверяю. I trust. Я доверяю. In this case, it's gonna be dative case because you give your trust to somebody. Я доверяю матрёшке. Матрёшка is here and I trust her. I don't even do anything. She's there, completely separate from me, and I trust her. Я доверяю ей. Dative case. Can I trust you can turn into accusative case? Can you spoil that? Of course you can. You can say Я доверяю матрёшку to God, to you. In this case, you actually do actions with матрёшка. You take it and you trust it to God. Take it. I trust матрёшку to you. But if матрёшка standing there, I trust you. I gave you a trust. I don't actually do anything with you. Dative case. And if I trust you to God, я беру тебя, and I'm trusting you to God. In this case, it's gonna be accusative. Я доверяю матрёшку Богу. I trust матрёшка to God. The same with я советую. I advise, советую. Again, accusative case, dative case. Я советую матрёшке. Dative case. I give матрёшка advice. She's there separate from me. I gave her advice. And can it be accusative case? It can. If you take матрёшка and you're gonna advise this матрёшка to somebody else. Guys, советую матрёшку купить. I advise you to buy матрёшка. Accusative case. Советую матрёшке, give advice to матрёшка, and take матрёшка and advise it to you. And советую матрёшку её вам. I do some action with матрёшка. Ooh, матрёшку. After a certain verbs in Russian, you can use accusative case and you can use sometimes genitive case. Like, я хочу выпить воду. I wanna drink water. Я хочу выпить воды. I wanna drink water. What's the difference? No, accusative case, it's knows what he wants. It's a particular guy. He's aiming on particular things. Whereas genitive case, kind of in general, English equivalent, I want the water and I want water. Any water will do, genitive case. So, because in English, in Russian, we don't have the, all impact goes to cases, goes to the ending. This is how you... So the ending carries a lot of information on their shoulders, on their tail. Okay? So don't be surprised if you say мне воду. Waitress can do something like... Wait a minute. Did you say воду? Вам минеральную или обычную? Do you want mineral? Or usual one. Also, don't be surprised if you say воды and waitress just gone. This water, it's warm. But then again, I didn't use accusative case. Doesn't seem like I know what I want. Doesn't sound like accusative case to me. The same if you say вода can go to водка. Водка. If you say, я хочу водку. You know the one with the red label Smirnoff on the second shelf? This is the one. Я хочу водки. Any водка will do. The, accusative case and genitive case. It's the same with я хочу любовь, я хочу любви. Because it's soft sign, feminine gender, we're not gonna change it. And любви, genitive case. First one. It's really rough translation to put that. It's more like я хочу любовь. It's look like I know what I'm talking about. I know what kind of love I want, and я хочу любви. I don't know yet what shape it will turn and what kind of love it's gonna be, but I know one thing, I just want love. In general, I don't give you particular information, but when you say я хочу любовь, I have an idea that you know what you want, what you really know, what kind of love you want, you know? So this is the difference. He doesn't go around the bush really, accusative case. He knows what he wants. For example, after ждать, to wait. If you use animate object like living things, my friend, my boyfriend, you, Marina, we using accusative case because the only one I know what I'm talking about, right? I'm particular, I'm accusative case. So я жду, let's say я жду друга, masculine gender here. Я жду подругу, feminine gender here. Я жду тебя. Я жду поезд. Поезд is not a living thing, so я жду поезд. Accusative case, why is that? Because я жду particular train, the one that coming at 8 o'clock. This is the train I'm waiting for. But sometimes in a everyday conversation, you can say я жду поезда. Я жду поезда. I'm just waiting for a train.
Я прошу дать мне ложку. Он дает мне ложку. Он передает мне ложку.
If you imagine, if you are this spoon, I am the spoon, for now, just hypothetically. Your spoon. Wouldn't be any difference if somebody pass you something. I'll pass in you a spoon. Take it. It's yours. Or if somebody take you and pass you to somebody. I'm passing you to somebody. And I pass you somebody. It's gonna be have a lot of difference, isn't it? You will react differently if I take you and pass you to somebody. Or if I pass you a present. Different reactions, different story, different case. Кручу ложку. Смотрю на ложку. Гну ложку. Даю ложку. Люблю ложку. Ненавижу ложку. Like, they're all different verbs. I love you, I hate you, I take you, I bend you, I pass you over. But you can see the algorithm. It means you experience some physical or strong emotions on yourself. So if you're a spoon, you will feel the same, you will react. And spoon in Russian language will react, or any other noun. And then of course adjective, because you see in Russian spoon, silver. It wouldn't be silver if it wasn't for spoon. That's why everything that has to do with spoon, the silver spoon, will react as if it was a spoon, exactly the same bit. Ending gonna change and stuff like this.
Хорошо, его зовут Marshall. Let's put Marshall in accusative case. It's a masculine gender animate. Let's put him in accusative case. Она целует Маршала. How Marshall reacts in accusative case? If we put Marshall in another case where he just sit next to somebody, He will react differently. Words will react differently. It's just different situation, different Marshall, different words, different endings, different case. We also can put Marshall in dative case. When we give something to Marshall, look at him, he reacts differently. Мы даем шапку Маршалу. We give hat to Marshall. The only thing that here in accusative position, it's a hat because we're actually passing it around. We gave it to Marshall, so we do something with hat. But Marshall itself in a dative case because we're giving something to him. You see, it's different case, he reacts differently, and words, endings react differently as well because it's a different Russian case.
Я даю эту ложку, ложке. I give something to her. Я стою с ложкой. I'm standing next to the spoon. У меня есть ложка. Any actions? No? I just have it. But у меня нет ложки. I don't have a spoon. I'm lacking something. I don't have spoon. There is some reaction here. Just like people. Just like people. Russian cases, they're just like people.
Дай лапу. Дай лапу. Лапу дай руку. Лапу, лапу давай. Давай лапу. Лапу дай. Лапу дай. Вот так.
Лапа becomes лапу. Give me your paw. Give me your something. I want your something.
Дай лапу. Дай лапу. Лапу дай руку. Лапу давай. Давай лапу. Лапу дай. Пойдите, все потихонечку. Ой, мой хороший. Давай лапу. Лапу дай. Дай лапу. Лапу дай. Тогда дам тебе ее.
Saying, give me your paw, then I will give you cookie. Cookie, печенька, feminine gender, ее. Тогда дам тебе. I will give it to you. So, not тебя, not ты, but тебе, dative case. I will give it to you. Give it to you what? Her. So, you put cookie in accusative case because I will give you her. Two cases in one sentence.
Лапу дай. Вот, молодец. Ну-ка, смотри.
Я снимаю.
Молодец. Молодец. Дай лапу еще. На, ну на, на, на. Не хватай.
По-зимней. И мы сейчас будем проводить эксперимент. Я сейчас роняю варежку. Сейчас он отвернется. И мы варежку уроним. Вот я бросаю варежку. Я ее потеряла. Теперь я ему говорю. Яша! Яш! Яша! Я варежку потеряла! Яш! Яша! А где варежка? Я потеряла варежку. Вот он понесся за варежкой. Сейчас принесет. Ай, какой умный мальчик, нашел варежку мою, спасибо. Огромное тебе спасибо, спасибо, молодец.
Ложка. What's the difference between я говорю про ложку, accusative case, и я говорю о ложке, prepositional case? Я говорю о ложке. Ложка серебряная.
Она из металла. Это ложка
15 сантиметров.
Это ложка твердое вещество.
Эта ложка можно есть. Окей. Now I'm gonna use accusative case.
Ненавижу эту ложку. Почему я взяла ложку?
I love this spoon. Я люблю эту ложку.
Это самая лучшая ложка в мире. Это просто самая лучшая ложка в мире.
Это просто самая лучшая ложка в мире. Смотри на эту ложку. Я говорю про ложку. IQ spoon. It's not the right spoon, eh?
Ложка helps us to eat. Ложка has a red color. La la la.
Prepositional case. Now, what about adjectives? Pronouns. Моя серебряная ложка. My silver spoon. Ложка. Feminine gender. Nominative case, nothing happening, basic form. Adjective silver became the same. Feminine gender, basic form, nothing happening. My pronoun becomes exactly the same. Copied adjective and noun. Basic form, nominative case, nothing happens. Я люблю. I love ложка. Ложка reacts to my love. Я люблю ложку. Spoon got impulse from my love. Now it carries information here about my love. It will transmit it to adjective. My, silver, серебряную. And also it will go further to pronoun my you. It's like a nervous system. Everything reacts. Noun is the boss. Everything copy the boss. Я люблю мою серебряную ложку. Я смотрю на мою серебряную ложку. Я гну, I bend, мою серебряную ложку. Ложка reacts every time, whether I look at her, whether I love her, I bend her. It reacts on my action, on my head, on my emotion, even on my look. What happens if I erase everything? It's not here. Okay? Even though it's not here anymore, now logical carries information about that. I know that something happened with spoon. There is action toward that spoon. What will happen if I erase the spoon? I know that something happening with the silver my. Okay, what happened if I erase that? This information goes here. Something happening with my something. So it's like a circle, DNA code. Everything support each other. Я даю мою серебряную ложку. Я беру мою серебряную ложку. Я смотрю на мою серебряную ложку. My black car. The boss here, of course, it's a noun. So if noun is feminine gender, adjective becomes feminine gender, and even pronoun becomes feminine. So they all, like a domino effect, copied. The same with девушка, красивая, это. This is this beautiful girl, feminine, feminine, feminine. Masculine, вид, view, masculine gender. Adjective, masculine, этот, consonant, this becomes masculine as well. This beautiful cat, masculine, consonant. So this adjective that describing our cat that is beautiful becomes masculine beautiful, and this because masculine this. All right, and this is feminine. What will happen with these words if I'm gonna love them? Or if I wanna kill them? Я люблю, I love. We know that feminine gender words become у. I love car, я люблю машину, у. Not only the car react to my love. Black that describing our car as well. It becomes чур, ну, ю. It's the same letters, you see. The only reason there is no U here, otherwise it's gonna be U, because if you say чорну U, it's hard to say. That's why the letter U came to our rescue. So we won't twist our tongue. Чорную машину. But they kind of like that they're in the same group. What will happen with my, моя? The same story gonna happen with mine. My you or mau? What do you think? U or you should I put there? Mau or my you? My you sounds easier. Мою черную машину. So now я люблю мою черную машину. I hide my love. I don't say anything. Мою черную машину. If I heard something like this, I would have assumed that I broke my black car, I fixed my car, I loved, or you loved, whoever loved the car, or, depend of intonation, you wanna sell the car, you wanna do something with the car. You're direct to the car. Хорошо. The same manner. Это красивая девушка, this beautiful girl. So, I love this beautiful girl. Start with the noun. Noun is the boss. У. Я люблю девушку. Now, the adjective copy. У. У. You. Because it's two letters here that we need to change. Here's only one, and here's two letters. Because the ending in adjective is two letters. So, красивую девушку. What happened with это? Easy, ooh. Everybody say, ooh, adjective. Everything, ooh, so cool, you love this girl. Эту красивую девушку. Mm-hmm. Masculine gender. What will happen with masculine gender? Я люблю этот красивый вид. Nothing happens. Except if we're talking about the living things, like animals, if we're talking about people, something that alive, person. For example, I love this beautiful cat. So now, even though it's masculine gender, it's gonna react all right. It's gonna react. We're gonna put A on the end. Кота. Let's say Fёдор. I love this beautiful Fёдор. Name Фёдора. It's gonna be name, right? Я люблю кота. I love this cat. What will happen with adjective for this particular case, masculine gender, that person or animal? О, красивого кота. And this gonna be этого. Этого красивого кота. This is the endings. For adjective, accusative case, masculine gender, for living things. Like list of this and go through like a drill, do it several times so it just got stuck in your mind. It will be good. Хорошо. So if you take away the steam. Okay. So this is gonna be our formula for adjectives. Adjectives. You can put any other adjective, for example, хорошая, good. Хорошая, хорошая, хороший. Mm-hmm. Or you can take any adjective, and it's gonna be the same endings. Uy, uy, I, or over for accusative case. This is for adjectives. Okay. So the same here. Any noun that ending on a, that feminine gender, gonna be u. Any noun that ending on consonant, gonna end on consonant, gonna stay exactly the same with masculine gender. And any noun that alive, gonna change to a, uya. Noun. So this is the ending for nouns. And even preposition or pronoun, gonna be you, yours, твою. Yours, твою, вашу, yours, formal. Мою, mine, твою, yours. Я люблю мою акулу. Here you can see that not only shark, акула, changed, also mine took accusative form. Я люблю мою акулу. So they in one team. Я кормлю моего медведя. Okay, медведь. Masculine gender word. Living thing. We need to change it to медведя. Not only that. My bear need to be changed to accusative form as well. So, моего медведя я кормлю. Я кормлю моего медведя каждый день. Мы празднуем нашу свадьбу. Okay. Наша свадьба, nominative case, nothing happening. If we celebrating our wedding, наша свадьба becomes to нашу свадьбу. Покажите ваши русские паспорта. Окей, паспорта, plural, passports, русские, Russian for plural. Nothing changed, because plural in accusative case is not changing. Покажите ваши русские паспорта, easy. Зацените его штангу, check out his barbell. Зацените его штангу. Посмотри на моего белого коня. We start with the horse because it's a noun. Determine the gender. Конь, masculine gender, living thing. We need to change it to коня. After that, we need to change adjective, white, белого, and we need to change pronoun, mine. They all become masculine gender in accusative case. Посмотри на моего белого коня. Look at my white horse. Check it out. Я смотрю на мою серебряную ложку. Я гну серебряную мою ложку. Word order in Russian, it's actually easy and very funny part. Я люблю моя серебряная ложка. It doesn't make sense without us changing the endings. Now, when we change it, я люблю мою серебряную ложку. Now it makes sense. After it makes sense, we can shuffle words around. You can put мою on the end of the sentence. Ложку in the first place. Ложку серебряную мою я люблю. In this case, you emphasize the spoon, that this is the spoon that I love. I love on the first place. Я люблю серебряную мою ложку. You see, the ложка was act upon. The silver, as an extension of the spoon, was act upon, and even my. So if spoon is loved, silver is loved, and my is loved, they wouldn't be mine if it wasn't for a noun, like mine what? If it wasn't for spoon, there wouldn't be silver. So every word now
carry information about the spoon, the word order doesn't matter anymore. You actually can play with this, and this is what Russian people do. Just be prepared that it's not going to be any words order in Russian speech. And just try it yourself. It's fun. If you want to emphasize the love, я люблю серебряную мою ложку. Emphasize the spoon, that this is the spoon that you love. Ложку, мою серебряную люблю. You want to emphasize silver? Go ahead. You want to emphasize that it's mine? Мою ложку серебряную я люблю.
Okay, let's make it the whole way. Let's make it adjective. Punch into right leg. Okay, what's not right here? It's nominative case, nothing happens. But it's actually happening. There is a punch going to the right leg. So it's going to be accusative case. В правую ногу. Now we write. В правую ногу. To the right leg. To the left arm. The same here, it's nominative case, nothing happens. Now, the punch going to левую руку, плечо, it's a neutral gender, so nothing change here. It's gonna be, let's say, в правое, it's gonna be ending for neutral gender, just a normal one. Удар в правое плечо, to the right shoulder. Let's go crazy, let's go this all the way, let's say, punch into your left. Удар. Удар. Punch. В. Into. Okay, твой. Yours. This is masculine gender. We need feminine gender. Твоя. After we established it's a feminine gender, we need to change it. Too much. Ау. Ногу. Правую. Ую. У. У. Ой, sorry, it's gonna be you. Твою. У твою. It's not sound right. Удар в твою. Ю. Правую. Ногу. Удар в твою левую руку. Again. Basic form is a feminine. Okay, so it's a feminine gender. It's gonna be твою левую руку. Удар в твою левую руку. Hit in your left hand. И удар в твою. This is just a normal basic form neutral gender. В твое правое плечо. It can look difficult, but it's actually not, because look at this. Here is the same letters over and over again. They all reacted, you know, not just noun reacted, ногу, but right reacted as well, ую, and even yours reacted. Everything, it's like a team. So you see, and even the letters, they just repeat itself. It's rather у or ю, very easy. So твою, ую, у, ю, ую, у. Твою правую ногу, твою левую руку. In my left hand. This is how leg reacts.
Медвежонок атакует правую ногу. Правую ногу. Медвежонок атакует правую руку. Правую руку. Серьезный оппонент.
Стрел, меня схватил за шею.
Я не хочу в холодную воду. Вода. Feminine gender becomes у, and cold adjective becomes ую as well. They one big family, they in a team. Я не хочу в холодную воду. Хочу на другую планету. The same here.
another planet, другая планета, feminine gender. We need to change both words. Другую планету. Хочу на Луну. Я одеваю моего кота в русскую одежду. Here we can see double accusative case. I'm dressing my cat. Direct object. Кот, living thing, need to change to кота. And my becomes masculine accusative as well. Я одеваю моего кота. And then, look at that. Inter. Direction. Inter the Russian clothes. Clothes, одежда. Feminine gender need to change to одежду. Russian need to change to ую as well. So it match our одежду. Я одеваю моего кота в русскую одежду. Double accusative case here. So, accusative case, he can be aggressive sometimes, pushy, straightforward, knows what he wants. I want you. I'm waiting for the train. Doesn't go around the bush. It's look like I'm describing a guy. Well, it is a guy because падеж case, it's a masculine gender. So, it's a guy in a way. You can experience action on yourself from accusative case. I love you. You love me on yourself, experiencing love or something.
Я влюблен в тебя, Россия, влюблен.
Я влюблен в тебя, Россия, влюблен. So direct object is gonna be тебя. He already changed this one into accusative case. Я влюблен в тебя. So Russia remains the same. You don't need to say Россию. If there wasn't тебя here, you would have said я влюблен в Россию. I'm in love with Russia. So direct. I'm in love with her. First one is already changed. You don't need to change the second one. Like, я влюблен в тебя, Наталья. Я влюблен в тебя, Ольга. Я влюблен в тебя, Сара. Я влюблен в тебя, Россия. And this is the guy who's singing the song. You can take it from the ending here. I'm in love, because it's a consonant ending. It's a male. If, let's say, I'm singing this song that I'm in love in Russia, I would have put A here. Я влюблена в тебя, Россия. Влюблена. In love. But this is a guy singing this song, so we just leave it like this with consonants. Я влюблен в тебя, Россия. Влюблен.
Я влюблен в тебя, Россия. Влюблен. Золотая рожь, да кудрявый нос. Я влюблен в тебя, Россия, влюблен. Ой, золотая рожь, ой, кудрявый лен. Ой, о том, как я в Россию влюблен.
Now the sentence is changing a little bit. Ой, о том, как. Ой, sing, how. Ой, о том, как я. Россия will come here. Я в Россию. We just changed the word order a little bit. Россию влюблен. I'm with Russia in love. Again, direct. And in this case, basic form Россия, Russia, becomes I'm in love with her, with Russia. В России you. Ой, о том, как я в Россию влюблен. Sing about how I'm in love with Russia. Ой, золотая рожь и кудрявый лен. Ой, о том, как я в Россию влюблен. I'm in love with her. Her Russia, Россия is she, feminine gender, and I'm in love with her. Я в Россию влюблен. Я в Марию влюблен. Я в Сару влюблен. Я в Наталью влюблен. Я в страну влюблен. Я в Россию влюблен.
Ой, золотая рожь, ой, кудрявый лен, ой, о том, как я в Россию влюблен. Ой, золотая рожь, ой, кудрявый лен.
Ой, о том, как я в Россию влюблен. Золотая рожь, да кудрявый лен. Я влюблен в тебя, Россия, влюблен.